Today we're going to talk about the RepRap Discount Full Graphics Smart Controller on the SKR version 3 by Big Tree Tech. Now, this is rather simple to install, and if you watched my previous tutorial that there's a link for in the description, you'll see that we need to know what EXP1 and EXP2 are on the SKR version 3 board. But we also need to use our RepRap Discount Full Graphics Smart Controller as well. So on the back of this, there'll be matching ports with the notch connectors on these ribbon cables. So let me point out a couple of things on this real quick. We have our contrast control right here that you can adjust. I don't suggest it. Then we also have our reset button, our piezo buzzer, and then our potentiometer to select by turning and then pushing down a menu. So on the back side of this, we have EXP1 and EXP2, as well as our SD card port. So there's going to be some special stuff that you have to set up because they changed the configuration in Marlin. So I'll show you that in just a second, but first I'm going to show you how to hook up these cables. So to start with, we'll take the notch connector on here and place it in EXP1. Then we'll take the notch connector here and place it in EXP1 on the board. After that, we'll do the same for EXP2 with the notch connector. And then we'll place the notch connector once again in EXP2 over here. Now I might not have it lined up correctly, so let me flip it over. There we go. So let's rotate that over. Now there is going to be something that I'm going to need to point out, so I'll show it to you real quick. And that is, we need to know what the MCU is on the board. And written on this is STM32H4-something. So that tells us what our processor is. So I'll show you how to confirm that in just a second. So let's go over to the desktop so we can actually try this out. So here we go. Over on the desktop, we need to open our file, which we downloaded from over in here. And let me bring that up so you can see it. So over in here, I've gone to the marlinfirmware.org for the downloads. And I'll leave a link in the description for you, but I'm using the current Marlin release, which is 2.1. So you can download it over in here. So I'm gonna minimize this for a second. I've already downloaded and extracted it over in here. So what we'll do now is we'll click on the File Explorer, Open Folder. Then what we'll do is we'll go to the Downloads folder, Marlin 2.0, Marlin 2.1, excuse me, 2.1 and then 2.1, then select the folder. Inside the folder, we need to find out what our processor is going to be because it's not the Mega 2560, it's So we'll do this by going to the Marlin folder, the source folder, then the core folder. Inside there, we'll find boards.h, and we'll search on SKR_V3, and that'll bring us to our board. So I'll highlight that and copy it. And as you can see, I actually got the processor incorrect. It's STM32H743. VG. Now this may be subject to change on future boards that Marlin makes for the same model, so keep that in mind in case there's a change. So I'm going to minimize the core source and then go to configuration.h, and I'm going to search on motherboard. And what you'll see right here is that we have the RAMPS configuration. That's the default. So we're going to paste what we just copied for our configuration. And then I'm going to change the serial port to -1. Now, a lot of people will tell you, or me, that you have to do zero here or one here for the touchscreen display. That is true and also false. You can actually do negative one down here for your motherboard as well, and then one here. I just prefer to do the motherboard first. So that's up to tastes and preferences. So now that we've got that configured, we do need to configure the display. So I'm going to search on rep wrap underscore discount underscore full, and that'll bring us to the actual option for our board. So I'm going to hit the control forward slash to remove the comment in order to use it. Now, up here, we do have some interesting information that we need to know about our board. So we're going to look for, I believe it's LCD and SD support. Now, many people that watch my tutorials might use it in a different language. So currently it's defaulted to English, but you can change it obviously to Deutschland or German. You can change it to Polska or Polish. And then, of course, you can change it to Ukrainsk or Ukrainian. There are a lot of different ways to configure it. But for now, I'm just going to leave it as is. Obviously, there's different types of configurations that you can set for your display. And of course, there's different character sets that you can use. In this case, I'm just going to leave it as default. Down below, we have to enable SD support so we can use the SD drive. So we'll remove the comment with a control forward slash. And then, of course, you can set up the SD check and retry, but it's not really necessary anymore. But if you're having issues with your SD card, it's a good place to start. Now, there have been some changes due to previous tutorials that I've done that where now there is an SD card in the board, so it gets confused. So I'll show you how to deal with that in just a second. I just want to go down through these directions a little bit more. Notice that there are other things that you can work with, but you'll have to experiment on your own because it gets beyond the scope of the tutorial, such as, reversing the direction of your menu. You can do this with the potentiometer that I spoke about, where you select menus by basically removing the comment, but we're going to leave that out for today. So the next thing I want to do is go over to Configuration Advanced, and I want to search on SD card underscore connection, and it should bring us right to it. Now it's currently commented out, and that means that it defaults to the onboard SD card if there is one. So I'm going to hit control forward slash so that it will now go to the screen that we're using for our display. So in order to set up the build now, we have to go over to Platform.io and we need to find our configuration for our default environment. So I'm going to click on the INI folder. I'm going to find our board chipset by going to the STM32H7 INI. And I'm going to highlight this section right here. Then I'm going to go back to Platform.io. So I'm going to minimize the INI folder for a second. And I'm going to paste this right here. Once I've pasted it right here, we're all set. So we're going to do a clean, which is the little garbage can down here. And that'll clean out the previous build that was in your actual download and extracted file. It was in the .pio folder for the Mega 2560. Now, to build it, you click on this little checkbox down here, and it should build no problem. But if there is an issue where it fails, click the checkbox a second time because something may have built out of order. And if you do still see an error, which is in red in here instead of yellow, that means that the error in red is the first thing that will not compile correctly due to the sanity check. So you'll have to fix that first, and then everything after that that fails with red, may be related to a cascade of errors due to the first error. So this is almost done. So if we click on the .pio folder, you can see the build in here for our chipset. In a second, you'll see firmware.bin. So we'll give that a second more to actually make its appearance. You'll probably see a firmware.elf first. And it should be coming any second right now. So here we go, we got the elf. Now we'll get the bin in a second. So in order to load this, we have to go back over to the desktop for a second. So what I'm gonna do is go back over to the workbench. I'm actually going to take out the drive here that would go on the board, and I'm going to place it in my SD card reader, pardon me, and place this inside here. Now, to use this board, we normally would use the regular power supply that's over here for either 12 or 24 volts, but as you can see, it will not power in its default state with the USB power. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a jumper over here to allow us to power it with USB. Don't use this for your steppers, but you'll see that this is what it looks like when it powers up if you set it up correctly. So I'm going to pop this out and go back over to the desktop on the computer. I'm going to right click on firmware.bin and I'm going to reveal in File Explorer. Inside File Explorer, I'm going to right click and I'm going to send this to the E drive. And on the E drive over here, you can see there's a firmware.cur. This was the last known good build that took place and it's all capitalized. I also put a G code file on here just in case to see if something goes wrong, but that probably will not be an issue. So I'm going to actually delete this for now. So let's go back and over here, right click, and send this to the E drive. Now, as you can see, we have the firmware.bin. If it's successful, it'll be renamed when it's loading to firmware.cur. So I'm gonna pop the drive out and I'm gonna go back over to the workbench. I'm going to insert the drive. And now I've already loaded this once, so you can tell that my screen was already set up, but I'm showing you the steps involved. So I'm going to place this in here. The firmware is flashing, so it's installing. You've heard the beep that it's connected to the computer. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use an SD card to see if we can actually verify it works. So I'm going to insert this in here. Then I'm going to press here. And you can see that it has change media and print file media. So we'll click here. And as you can see, we've got a bunch of little things we can choose from for our media. Now, that is how you would actually print. So what I want to do right now is thank my patrons and people on PayPal for their donations. They're greatly appreciated and helps offset the cost to purchasing equipment and also keeping these tutorials going. And I will place a thank you note at the end for them. Also, please like and subscribe, and everyone take care, be safe, and I'll catch up with you later.